As far as iPods are concerned, I mean, nobody really follows this category because it was largely seen as something that was beginning to dissipate for this company. 10 million iPods was what was anticipated. It looks like Apple is reporting 20.97 million units sold on the quarter. As far as third quarter guidance is concerned, the revenue line that I saw, the midpoint of the range, $12.9 billion was what was anticipated. Apple is offering guidance of 13 to 13.4 billion and an EPS range of $2.28 to $2.39. The EPS midpoint there was 265, but remember that Apple always sandbags its guidance. But looking at that revenue line, this looks to be substantially better than what Wall Street was anticipating as far as the revenue range. But if you look down these individual units, Maria, my goodness, again, we're talking about a consumer that's just now trying to wake up from just a couple of years of bitter recession, and none of this seems to be affecting Apple in any meaningful way, especially when you look at that Mac line. We got that NPD research yesterday that I was telling you about that indicated that something well below 3 million units as far as Mac sales were concerned during the quarter, and Apple exceeding that substantially with 3.36. But that iPhone number is just enormous. And if I'm Research in Motion, just about anybody trying to play in the smartphone arena, I'm taking very careful notice of that particular metric indeed.
You know, Maria, back to you. It's interesting because the guidance seems quite impressive as well, Jim. I mean, and this is a company, David, that is typically conservative on guidance, isn't that right?
Very much so. And to the extent that the revenues are coming out as strong as they are, that's very good news. I think also the one thing that Jim ran through was the fact of how strong the iPod sales were. Think of iPods as a way of where Apple brings consumers into the low end of their product range and then migrates them up to higher ticket, higher margin products. The fact that iPods came out with a number twice what people were expecting, almost 20 million versus an expectation of roughly 10, that is significant and also argues well for what Apple is doing globally.
And do you see any pricing pressure? I mean, these things, mobile devices that typically have, you know, shelf life when it comes to pricing pressures, prices usually come down. You're not necessarily seeing that for the iPhone, are you?
Well, you're not really in a situation right now where you're seeing an effective competitor coming out with regard to the iPhone. You might have a lot of copies rolled out in some emerging markets such as China and others, but from the standpoint that Apple is able to maintain its pricing leadership facing that kind of competition speaks volumes for how well the company's doing, certainly supportive of the stock.